Pat, the Malaysian government says it has no doubt about what happened to flight MH370. They announced it crashed in a remote part of the southern Indian Ocean with no survivors. But as George Thomas reports, victims' families and the Chinese government want proof.
18 days after the Boeing 777 en route from Kuala Lumpur to Beijing went missing, Malaysia's prime minister announced satellite data shows the plane ended its journey in the remote seas west of Australia.
Flight MH370 ended in the southern Indian Ocean.
The CEO of the airline says, "We do not know why, we do not know how this terrible tragedy happened.
We're all praying for the passengers and crew."
And yet officials are still no closer to answering some of the most pressing questions. Why and how did the plane veer so drastically off course? Was it terrorism, hijacking, or mechanical failure? Britain's Daily Telegraph says sources close to the investigation believe the plane was deliberately crashed in an apparent suicide mission. Locating the plane's so-called black box is all the more critical before its signal dies in a few days.
The investigation underway may yet prove to be even longer and more complex.
For the families of the 239 people on board the Malaysian Airlines flight MH370, it was the news they feared the most.
Sadness and anger came pouring out as families tried to come to terms with the announcement.
They said the plane went down in the southern Indian Ocean, but they have not found the plane yet. What are they basing this on?
In Beijing, relatives of some of those on board demonstrated outside the Malaysian embassy, accusing them of hiding the truth. The Chinese government is also demanding the Malaysia release satellite images to back its claim that the plane went down in the Indian Ocean. No wreckage has yet been found, but experts fear the plane may have sunk some 23,000 feet under the Indian Ocean.
They say that none of them survived. I don't believe that. If you make such a conclusion, you must have some evidence.
Dangerous weather conditions forced Australian authorities to call off today's search. George Thomas, CBN News.